Sosa gave you all them clothes and give you to wear, glowed you up, and this is how you do little folks. You gonna do little folks like this? He gave them clothes.
Benny, why every time we see you out here, you got this same burger?
Sosa gave the shirt. I never take the shirt off. Benny,
why do you even take the shirt off?
Benny, Sosa gave the shirt. I never take the shirt off.
Benny, huh?
Benny.
Also, on shirt off. On Benny, huh?
Make sure y'all go watch the director's cut. This video you watching right here is literally the YouTube friendly version of the video you actually looking for. I can go there on the director's cut. I can't really go there like that on here. Even though Chief Keef took a slight shot at Mubu and War, you can't even really call that no shot. He just said he not one of them. Obviously Crump felt the same way, because if he didn't feel that way, he wouldn't have stood up for Sosa. Why would Crump stand up for Sosa if he feel like Sosa dissing Mubu? There's actually a few reasons why Mubu Crump stood up for Sosa. Crump had the same outlook on the situation that we did, just like we was looking like how they gonna go against Sosa. Sosa the reason that the whole world know y'all. Sosa the reason the world know about y'all neighborhood. Sosa the reason why y'all doing 100,000 on YouTube on your first video. And with Crump basically being second in charge over at Mubu, when he spoke on it, people took notice. So that's the first reason why I feel like Crump stood up for Chief Keef. The second reason I feel like he stood up for Sosa is obviously because he had his own agenda. He had his own beef with Boss Top. He had his own beef with OTF. So he gonna try to make them look bad any way he can, and he just so happened to have a good point. How the fuck y'all gonna go against the who put y'all on and made the world know who y'all is? And the third reason why Crump stood up for Sosa is cause he know, just like we know, that Sosa is the reason why Chicago lit like this. Even though King Louis was doing his thing, Mubu, they was all doing their thing. Just like everybody else benefited when Sosa blew up, Mubu benefited when Sosa blew up. And with Crump being the stand-up individual that he was, even though he know Mubu was doing his thing, even he noticed the increase in notoriety to Mubu. I feel like everybody should have appreciated the notoriety that Sosa brought to Chicago. Crump was just an individual who spoke on it, and without saying Sosa, I appreciate the notoriety, he stood up for him. And he ain't finna just stand up for nobody that he don't appreciate. But it was really easy for Crump to stand up for Sosa against these people he don't even like anyway. He don't even like them. Cause he already appreciated Sosa for what he did for Mubu indirectly. And I gotta keep saying indirectly, cause Sosa was trying to get himself on. He was trying to get his group on. He wasn't trying to get his ops on. Indirectly, he put on his ops. Basically, anybody who was doing music in the city of Chicago around 2012, you had a whole window to make something happen. And the three reasons that Mubu Crump stood up for Sosa in the O Block beef, for one, Mubu Crump seen the blasphemy and the ungratefulness from the immediate people around Sosa that he directly put on, intentionally put on. For two, the people that he stood up for Sosa against was people that he didn't like already anyway. And for three, Mubu Crump appreciated the notoriety that Sosa brought to the city of Chicago, which ultimately ended up benefiting everybody in the city who was rapping, including Mubu. Moving on to Lil Reese, as far as Lil Reese not standing up for Sosa, I feel like this is a clear-cut case of somebody being caught in the middle. Before you just jump to conclusion, you gotta remember the situation. Lil Reese grew up in these blocks. Lil Reese knew these people his whole life. Lil Reese is indebted to these people. Lil Reese got allegiance to these people. So before you just jump to conclusion and be like, oh, Lil Reese should have sided with Sosa off the rip, it shouldn't have been no question, you gotta hold on. Hold on, you just gotta remember. So now that you know how strong Lil Reese ties is with these blocks, we can move on to Sosa. We all know how the story with Sosa goes. Sosa end up getting signed at 16, Interscope, $6 million deal. And this is what it really come down to. Chief Keef carefully selected his people with extreme prejudice. Y'all know he didn't pick Dirt. We already know how the story go. He ended up picking Ball Out, Tato, Blood Money, Trey Sav, Fredo Santana, Lil Reese. Lil Reese was amongst this group that Chief Keef carefully selected. And I understand why he was so careful when he was picking these people, because look what ended up happening. And as people, we not dumb. We know who rock with us and we know who don't rock with us. So Sosa probably just looked at the list of people who rock with him and just chose all of them. And all the people who didn't rock with him over here, he was like, all right, I ain't bringing y'all. Y'all been not rocking with me, I already know what time it is. And he moved accordingly. He picked the people who rock with him. I'm saying all this to say that it should have been an honor. For the people who was picked by Sosa, it should have been an honor for them. Because he didn't have to choose y'all. I'm talking about even down to the cousins. He ain't have to choose none of y'all. He could have just, all right, 6 million up. And could have instantly did what Uncle Elroy did on next Friday. As soon as I got that check, I was gone. Paid 6 million cash for this place. He ain't say 6 million, but y'all know what I'm saying, though. He could have easily did what Uncle Air right there and ain't picked nobody and just got up out of there. I'm rich now. I don't got to bring nobody with me. But nah, he hand-selected his group of people that was rocking with him before he got on. So I'm saying all that to say that Lil Reese was amongst a group of people that Sosa honored and respected enough to take with him. And Lil Reese never publicly stood up for Sosa. That's what this is all about. Lil Reese never publicly came out and said, I don't honor how y'all trying to handle Sosa. I don't honor how y'all trying to handle my shorty right now. I feel like Sosa would have appreciated the gesture. I feel like Sosa would have honored what Reese said. He really just stayed out of it. And I don't really want to even say he stayed out of it. Because when Sosa hopped on Instagram and responded to Boss Top saying that he's sipping blood, and Sosa said, what if I would have said this about OD? And Lil Reese publicly hopped in the comments on Chief Keef's Instagram and told him to watch his mouth. Which brings me to my question. Do you ever think Sosa ever sit back like, I put bro on my biggest song? But when I got into it with some people back home and it was up between me and them, he chose they side. He never publicly told them that they was wrong for how they was handling the situation when I'm the one who made everybody know who y'all is. He never publicly said none of that. Do you ever think Sosa sit back and be like, man, I made a mistake? Soon as I said something, he publicly hopped on my Instagram where everybody could see and told me to watch my mouth. But like I said in the beginning, I feel like there's a clear-cut situation of somebody being caught in the middle of two parties that they got love for. And that's a real tough situation to be in. So can't nobody really judge Lil Reese when you think about it. Like, because we all have been in a situation where we got caught in the middle of two parties that we got love for. So you can't really judge, because when you was caught in that situation, you knew exactly what to do. Nah, you'll be capping. You'll be lying. You ain't know exactly what to do off the bat. Maybe after a while of thinking about brainstorming, probably came up with somewhat of an answer, but you ain't know off the bat what to do. That's a decision for a person to make on their own, for real, for real. So these situations that I'm speaking on, all us to notice these joints. Shout out to Lil Reese. Shout out to Chief Keef. Rest in peace, Moo Boo Crump. Shout out to everybody who keep putting up to the show. We need this video at 10,000 likes. Make sure y'all hop in the comments. All the members, I need y'all to go ahead and comment. I don't even care if you comment and say, the only reason I'm commenting is because Diddy told me. I don't care. I'm trying to see something. I'm really trying to let people know how we coming.